Hi and welcome. I'm John and this is Unique Wargaming Terrain. Guys, welcome back. For everyone that's new, this is the weekly Wednesday Wargaming questions and answers. It's an off-the-cuff video. What that means is I record and I upload. So if something happens, I can't control it. I do have a transition button, so if it starts raining really heavy, I can stop filming and then pick it up again. If there's noise in the yard or if there's animals crying out, I can't do nothing about it. This morning I came over here, I'm a little bit skittish at the moment. This morning I came over here half an hour, so I just do a few odd jobs. Mainly super glue work with some of the lead stuff that I've got flying around. And there was two massive dirty bioforms up there. And I got Hoover over, hoovered them, and I think they blocked the Hoover. So that looks like a job for the wife. So I'm a little bit skittish just in case I didn't get them and they're lurking up there somewhere. All my regulars here, guys, I feel love. Thank you very much. Now, so what are these weekly Wednesdays about? For everyone that's new, the weekly Wednesdays are essentially a Q&A. You ask me questions, I answer them. It is primarily model focused and it is primarily GW, 99% of the time, GW stuff. There is some terrain questions that come into weekly Wednesday sometimes and some information about myself and what's going on in and around the workshop. That's the gist of it. And there's a weekly vote to do with what you want me to paint next Monday. Just to remind everyone, I am still doing commission let's builds, commission painting and commission terrain pieces. Now, let's builds, if you don't have the time or the space to put models together or the patience, you know, chuck me a comment, give me a message and we'll sort something out. Painting as well, if you don't have the time and space or patience to paint, give me a shout. It can be battle ready, it can be finished, it can be just painted up to a certain point where then you come along with washes and dry brushes and everything else. Either way it's fine. If you want custom terrain pieces, give me a shout, because you guys, they're regulars here, and all the new people coming into the channel, you'll see some crazy stuff that I make, some absolute crazy stuff. At the moment, I have penciled in for this Saturday a live stream on TikTok. So those of you that are on TikTok, I have planned a live stream for Saturday at 7 o'clock in the evening. It might be slightly after that, I don't know, but that's what I've planned in. It may not even happen, but just, you know, if you are around and want to have a look and join me, then that's what I've planned in. Okay, so on to the questions. Are you going to be adding more boards to your new gaming boards? Yes, I am. There is a plan to do that. The problem is one sheet of that material. I didn't look at the price of the bigger board because it would be a nightmare to cut, but the smaller one is €8.50, I believe, €8.50, and I can get two pieces off of that. So what I was thinking of doing is doing like a double board, maybe getting two boards and doing one as a double board and do two as single boards, or even two doubles, but one of them just pretty much plain and the other one with mad crazy terrain on it. That's what I was thinking, because I did the cheap gaming boards made out of polystyrene basin, which is fantastic. And even if you don't want to go the way that I'm going, the new boards, and you want to do the old way, that's fantastic. You know, you can't go wrong with that. There's very little to no warping in the polystyrene ones. With the boards that I'm using, there is a little bit of warping here and there. You have to just really put a weight on it, hold it down, and you know, do some crazy stuff like that. But they are durable and more. There's less chance of them being damaged than the polystyrene-based ones. But the plan is to add a few more. Me and Alex were talking about it, and he said to me, you do need to do a few that are just not plain, that have a little bit of terrain here and there on them, but like a little wall or some sort of little barbed wire area, but it's basically open. So, you know, we were having a conversation there because there was a battle report we have planned. And I have an empty tile, but we need something like that. So that's... Sorry, if you're new here, this is what I do. I do just waffle on something else, but I'm going to be adding more stuff to the boards. how's the other 40k armies coming along? They actually come along pretty well. What's slowing me up at the moment is I've got lead models here that have 2,000 points that I had to strip. That most of them need to have arms, backpacks, space marine stuff. The Eldari stuff are just going straight into the base. I actually got one of those up on a weekly Wednesday for the vote this week. But the other stuff is just, I just have the time to organise what's going on who and what's going where. But it is coming along. Now, painting wise, I haven't had the time to do a painting video outside of the Monday painting video. Trying to get the time, but I'm back to full time work at the moment, so you know it's hard. But I'm on late for the next 2 days, so I might sneak a cheeky one in, you know, just pick a character out or something and just do a random one or something that I think I can do over the next couple of mornings. I'm not sure. It's coming along though, it's just having the time to get them finished. Once they're glued together, I mean, look, I've got this Wraith Lord. Yeah, I've got his arm, his other arm. I'm missing his head. And I can't find his head. So I've got an old plastic jet bike in now. I might have to take the top of that chassis off of that and then glue that out to make his head. But, you know, this model is the one with the little peg in the foot. Yeah. That's meant to go in the square base. So I'm going to have to snip that off and his legs come loose. Oh, yeah, of course he would. His legs just come loose. Yeah. But that's... I'm getting there. Okay. What do you prefer, base terrain or freestanding terrain? Now, I do prefer freestanding terrain. Only because then you haven't got to mess around with base. And you haven't got to try and make the base look like it goes with other stuff. And, you know, even though for me, when I do terrain and it's on base or even like the boards, I try and do the same colour scheme. But I do prefer freestanding terrain because it's a lot easier just to go plonk, plonk, you know, wherever you want it. So I have a few pieces of polystyrene that I broke off when I was making the boards that I made. Yesterday's video. So you know, I do prefer freestanding terrain, but sorry guys, those of you that know me know that I'm a bit off my game because I just don't want to be here talking and I see something come down. These are like tarantula size, absolutely horrible. Anyway, I do prefer freestanding, but it depends. Also depends on the terrain piece. Because if it needs to be based and it has a reason for being based, you know, it's just... Right. How's your game you're working on coming along as you haven't spoke about it recently? Now, that game, it's not come along as much as I would have wanted because I've been so focused on trying to bring you guys battle reports. But at the moment, I'm so focused on trying to get more models done for different armies. So instead of it being Necrons and Space Marines and you're adding more stuff to them and building them up to play games with, I'm trying to get the others sorted out, like the Chaos Space Marines and the Demons. I'm so hell-bent on getting the Demons organised and ready for when the Codex drops. Again, the Eldari, I'm trying to get them up. I've probably got close to 1,000 points of Eldari. But they just need to be painted. And codex ball for him. So I mean, you see me build Mr. Ra the other day, or the other weeks I say. There's some fire dragons on here. There's Dire Avengers. There's Swooping Hawks. I think I've got all aspect warriors, at least a unit of each, apart from Striking Scorpions, which I have. No, sorry, Warp Spiders, which I have one Warp Spider, and I think Dark Reapers. I have one Dark Reaper because the old lead ones used to come in a blister pack. I think it was one or two of them, something like that. And there's a Dark Reaper Exarch with the flail with the skulls on top and his little shrunken pistol. But I think the plan with them is to turn them into Autarchs. Is that the correct, the HQ choice? The Eldari HQ choice that can have different Aspect Warrior gear. Something like that. Just because they're the spare models sitting around, I can't do nothing with them. But the demons are coming along. Everything else is coming along. And I've been so focused on them, I haven't actually sat down. Like, the wife's at work now, so I would be... this should be the time where I sit down and start doing stuff on the game. But because I've got lots of stuff to glue off camera, I haven't... I would be doing that rather than writing the rules for the game. But it is there. It is nagging away at me. I do want to get it done. So it's still a work in progress, you know, but it will be coming soon, hopefully. Hopefully within the next couple of months I can have it finished and start making prototypes, terrain for it, and start, introducing you slowly to what I'm doing. So what I'm going to do now is that's all the questions I had this week. I'm going to bring you down a second, show you what the vote's for, and then you can cast your votes. Now, if you have any questions for me, guys, please drop a comment below. Or if you don't want to chuck a comment below because you think, oh, everyone's going to see it and I don't want people to become silly or anything like that, don't panic. There's no silly questions. Go on to Unique Wargaming Terrain Facebook page. There is a messenger button there. You can click on that and you can message me directly. And if you do it that way, I won't mention your name or anything like that. I'll just ask the question and answer the question. So I'll bring down and show you the voting, and then with the voting, what you want to do, what has to be done is you chuck a comment below on the video to say what you're voting for, to see me paint next Monday's painting video, and the voting stops at 12 midday on Friday. Now, if it's 1 o'clock, I go there and look at the voting, it's 1 o'clock, but it's around midday on Friday. In the event of a voting tie, like last Monday just gone, then I do a D6 roll off. So last Monday it was the Skitarii Rangers and the Necron Immortals. Done D6 roll off. Necron Immortals got the roll off, so they were painted up. So now I'm going to bring down and show you the models and then what's going on. Right, so we still have Chaos Cultists with the two dust. I haven't even glued to the base yet because I'm so trying to focus on everything else. We have Seekers. The Demonette Seekers. We have the Chaos Chosen. Again, this guy at the front here, I don't think he would be part of the Unix. I think it's only a 5-man team. If someone knows the answer to that, please, because I haven't got a Chaos Spaceman College yet, please check on below and let me know. Because I'm sure it's a 5-man Chosen Chaos Space Marine unit. We have Mr. Ra at the back there. It's a fantastic model. I have Fire Dragons here. I know there's a couple of Dire Avengers to the side here, but just there is Fire Dragons. Now, a few of them have a little bit of yellow gunky stuff dried on them. I still have to clean them off, but it's not a big issue. I have the Engines here, which is a man here with a big axe. I have the Demonettes. I have Skitarii Rangers. I have the Blood Crushers, which are the corn guys on the big Juggernauts. I have 3 Blade Guard veterans with the swords, 3 Eradicators with the big guns behind. There is an assortment of heroes at the back there. From left to right is going to be Blade Guard veteran ancient, the Judicar or Judasar, and there's 2. I think they're captains. One has a shield, which is this dude. It's an amazing shield. We have the Chaos Lord here with his plasma pistol. And we have the Illumina, the big Necron dude, everyone keeps calling him. Just to give you an idea, here's the lead that I'm working with. Yeah? And there's more in there as well. I also have this lot over here to be working with, and there's just so much. There is also a wild card. Now the wild card is, you'll find out if it gets voted for. Okay, the wild card has been voted for before, and it was the Jabba's Wife, which, you know, I went to town with contrast paints and everything else, you know, mediocre hobby style of painting, and I absolutely loved it. So well done, thank you, Andy, for, you know, bringing that information to us and showing us how easy contrast paints are to use. Now, some of you are going to be a little bit disappointed because the Kitbashed Bloodthirster isn't in the vote. It will be eventually, but for now, for the minute, I'm not entirely happy with it being finished. It's not finished yet to me. I'm going to take a collar from the Blood Crusher kit, one of the collars that goes around the Juggernaut. I want to try and pin that around his neck. There's a few other bits and pieces that I want to try and add to his base. Now, I was thinking of getting all the leftover heads that I have and snipping them down and cleaning them up and gluing them across the base to make like a skull, you know, skulls everywhere. I was also thinking in the giant kit, there's things like there's a skeleton inside of a cage. I was going to try and incorporate him on there somewhere. I was thinking at the bottom of the axe head, you know, the axe handle, but I'm not really sure on that. There's a few bits and pieces that I want to put to it, but I'm not sure on it yet. But again, I'm late for the next 2 days, so I'll probably just bring it over and start working away on it. So don't be disappointed, because it will be coming soon. I know the moment it hits the voting, it's going to be voted on. I know that already. Same as the pipes that came in, I knew straight away that was going to be voted on. Any place of terrain that comes over here, I knew straight away that's going to be voted on. So, guys, don't forget to vote. Surprise me this week. Thank you, everyone, for watching, and thank you for everyone's continued support. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, guys, it costs you nothing. Just hit the subscribe button, turn your notifications on, and it's, you know, it helps the channel out in a huge, huge way. So, you know, thank you to everyone that is subscribed and that's, you know, enjoying what I'm doing, because it does mean a lot to me. Guys, until next time, hit like, share, subscribe. Like, share, subscribe. Turn on your notifications. Until next time, take it easy, guys. Don't forget to vote. See you later.